Welcome back to this new inspirational video. Today I wanted to go over the concept by Emmett Fox. Life is consciousness. In one of his lectures, he once said that they hold the key to life, which is to know that all of life is consciousness itself. Now I wanted to further go on this point to hopefully give you some better awareness on how to go about this and how to use this in your life. First of all, if we turn to the Bible, there's one called Psalm 27 that started out by saying, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even mine enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell." Now, an important fact about the Bible is that we have to observe it from a spiritual perspective. The Bible, in reality, is talking about consciousness all over the place. It's talking about the fact that we can control our minds and that we're actually called upon to become masters of our minds. When they talk about war in heaven and the forces of evil, we have to understand and connect the dots, because heaven is within, as Jesus said. So if you connect the dots, the constant reminder becomes that all of life is consciousness and all of heaven and hell take place inside our own individual mind. And that is what we are called upon to master, to become masters of our own minds. So we might see the salvation of a God, the spirit of life, can only work through us if our minds are prepared to work with it. Now, if life is consciousness, does that mean that anything becomes possible to me if I understand my own consciousness? Well, the answer to that is yes. Everything becomes possible. The beautiful part is that we have to understand that consciousness itself is eternal. It is an eternal power. It is your own awareness of being. The difficulty we have is that at times we might reason, well, if that is true, why can't I remember what I was, or who I was, or what I was doing before I was born into this physical life? This all ties back into the concept of reincarnation as well, as many certain religions and spiritual movements consider. Personally, the idea of reincarnation can be true. I don't have currently any knowledge or awareness of a past life, but at the same time, we were also warned not to look back to the dead past. So a past life is essentially in the past, if we've had one, which, again, there's many theories that we do have one, and I've heard many stories of people who claim to have knowledge of their own past life, so it seems to indicate it is true. But does that actually help us right here and now? Perhaps the reason why we're looking at those concepts is because we want to understand our eternal nature, to have some evidence that it's true, that we are eternal beings. Because sometimes, or most of the times, it's very hard to grasp. But if we can just study our own consciousness, we will find out that it is true. We don't have to look at past lives. We can look in the present and start working with our consciousness to discover, to our great joys, that life is indeed a state of consciousness, a state of awareness. So what will happen to a person once they grasp that their own mind is their own power for salvation? Well, one of the things that will start to happen to anyone is that they start to have very peculiar visions at night when they are asleep, highly spiritually charged visions that show them different realities that exist within the universe. There are different dimensions through which consciousness can move, showcasing us that indeed this physical life is not all there is to it. If you catch yourself being aware in those realms, well, then you have clear evidence, no doubt about it any longer, that you were indeed in a totally different dimension of the universe. Somebody once asked me, if we die, where do we go? I told them that is the greatest mystery of life. That is that mystery of life through death. I cannot pinpoint exactly where you will go. I can only say that you will move into another dimension of the universe, wherever that is. The easiest way for me to sort of prove this, well, fact of life is to ask anyone, if you're dreaming, where did the dreams take place? Usually we're not aware that we're dreaming. We just wake up and we're like, oh, I had a great dream, or I had a bad dream perhaps. But where did they take place? If you were to say they took place in my brain, that is totally absurd. If someone is in a coma, they can still say, once they get out of it, that it was like they were having a very long-lasting dream. Where did the dream take place? It didn't take place in your brain itself, because if that was the case, you could open up anyone's skull and then see the dream world just floating around in their brain matter. But that's not true. It's taken place in a different dimension of the universe. Awareness moves places. So how will life being consciousness bring us salvation? Well, it means that anything you face in your physical life can be overcome through the right use of that same consciousness. So what we're called upon to do is raise our level of awareness, become aware of deeper and bigger and better things that we're capable of doing, so that we can then apply it in our lives with wisdom. As long as we're ignorant, we can't outgrow the very things we're struggling with. That makes a lot of sense if you think about it. If you have a problem in your life and you currently don't know what to do about it, that's because you're ignorant on how to go about it. But yet you can find the answers to your problems, and then suddenly ignorance is replaced with wisdom, and there you go, you outgrow the problem you were facing. Even though at one point in your life the problem might have seemed insurmountable. That's the beauty of it all. And this is also why we need to keep an open mind. We don't necessarily have to keep an open mind about what other people are saying. You don't have to necessarily keep an open mind about what I'm saying. But what I will suggest is that you have to keep an open mind towards God, towards the spirit behind all of creation, because that is truly the power that will bring you the salvation that you're seeking, the comfort that you need, the wisdom, inspiration, the guidance. Anything you need comes from within, from the spirit of all life. And you can only lay hold of it, if you are aware that it is your own consciousness that is one with this spirit of life. In another video I once said, your consciousness is like a drop from a vast ocean called God. The ocean being God, being the spirit of life. And then your individual consciousness is like a little drop out of this massive ocean, and now you're here, in physicality. You have been born, and now you're meant to grow and expand and control your own mind. So you become one with God, literally. And you become capable of what God is doing, literally. Will that happen in time, space, reality? Perhaps for some people. But what really will happen is that you become master of your own consciousness, meaning that you can move through dimensions as will, and you overcome death itself. You understand you're an immortal being at that point, which you are. But from a point of ignorance, we have difficulty accepting this because we're only used to looking at the physical side of life. And here we can see people move and pass away. They are born and then they pass away after a little while. We have objects, they work, and then after a little while they break down and stop functioning. Then we have to get new objects to replace them. If we lose a friend because they're dead, well, if we want to have new friends, we have to let them go and embrace new ones. Things come and go in the physical dimension of time and space. But in the immortal realms of the mind, things never come and go. They exist forever and ever in all of eternity, and you can resurrect these things at will, if you're aware. That is the beautiful destiny that is in store for you, and that you have to lay hold of, and hopefully you will. I'm sure you will, if you're an honest student and truth seeker. You can always find this power for yourself once the time is right. You're already on your way towards realizing this. So any problem you have can be overcome by the right use of your own consciousness. Burn this deeply into your soul. That way you no longer give your power away to physical circumstances as they are. You don't feel like because the circumstances aren't in your favor that you'll be stuck forever. Because the sad part is, that is how most people operate. They really feel that way about themselves and about their predicament. But if you know it's consciousness that will set you free and bring you the salvation you seek, then it becomes a matter of studying your own consciousness, of becoming aware of what it is capable of doing, of becoming aware what it means to be aware itself. This is huge and powerful once it dawns upon you. One of the things you will understand is that you can use your consciousness in many ways. We can use our consciousness in such a way that it allows the physical world to control it, or we can become self-directed individuals and let consciousness be directed according to the visions that we decide upon. And this is the beautiful message of the Bible and of any other real spiritual teaching, is that the power to set you free comes from within. It resides inside of yourself. So during times of chaos in your own individual life, do you understand now what to do? If not, I will say it to you. You have to look to your own consciousness. Even Emmett Fox would say that. Life is consciousness. The state of your life depends upon how you are using your own consciousness. So how are you using it? Are you using it to build wonderful visions, have deep, meaningful purpose for yourself on which to act throughout your time here on planet Earth? Or are you just going along by what circumstances dictate? This is how we've been trained. It's a sad reality, but it's true. As a society, we're literally trained to just go along with how circumstances are, and therefore we never discover the true power of who we really are. But that is what we're called upon to discover, and it shouldn't be something you're ashamed of. Perhaps the people around you don't agree with what you're studying, or find it a little weird that you're studying these spiritual ideas, and that is because they are not on the same level of awareness that you are. They are not called upon yet to discover the power for themselves that they really are. And therefore we should just forgive them and let them live their lives in their own ways, while we dare to embrace our own eternal destiny. Because you're called upon to do this. If you're watching my videos, you're one of those people that is actually already called upon to discover the real nature of their soul, of their eternal spiritual self. Because otherwise you would never be listening to any of this sort of material. So there's already proof that you're ready to do so. The next step is to embrace it and to become one with the message, so you can apply it in your own life once and for all, and discover for yourself that life is indeed consciousness, because consciousness itself is a power that is eternal, that exists independent of the body. Your dreams are already hinting at this fact that you can walk in other dimensions of the universe, and once you physically were to die, your consciousness will simply shift focus and move on in another dimension of the universe. That is so beautiful, and that should give so much hope and peace, and gets rid of the fear of death itself. Of course, the dying process in and of itself, perhaps it might be a little scary, a little uncomfortable, but behind that experience itself, you will know there's so much more beauty yet to behold and to discover for your eternal self. And that will help us make it so that you also feel less sad about people who pass away. See, that might seem shocking, because in a way it's normal to feel sad when somebody passes away, but at the same time, if you know they're also eternal beings, you can be happy for them at the same time. Maybe they were very sick, they were suffering a lot, so at least they're free now. But now we gain the awareness of true eternal nature, and when we say they are free now, we know it from a much deeper perspective, instead of just some novel idea being like, well, at least they don't suffer in their body. Instead, we learn to say, at least they don't suffer in their body, and what a marvelous journey they must be on, discovering even more beauties of the eternal nature of life itself. Therefore, remember the words that life is consciousness, and it is through the way you use your consciousness that you will either improve your life or bring it to total destruction and chaos. It all depends on how we're using it. Have a clear idea of what you desire to express while you're here, and then use your consciousness to keep yourself focused on that dream, on that desire, on those visions. And then it will bring you the salvation that you've been seeking all along. It will come from within, and then it will be expressed through the body into the world. If you're new to this channel, consider subscribing to receive inspirational videos on a regular basis. And with that being said, dear viewer, never forget that we are the dreamers.